What is this? Will he survive?
In this world we live in, nothing happens by accident. His Excellency's helicopter did not just fall from the sky, just like that. My being the deputy governor is not also by accident. I was chosen to carry out our planned program. His Excellency, he will pass a new government in this world.
Well said. Well said. In that case, I will say, congratulations, Your Excellency.
Thank you.
You will make an excellent governor.
And you also will make an excellent partner in this
world. Well, I'll be running along. Have a nice day, Your Excellency.
Freed me when I was 24. By now, I should be able to stand and take care of myself and my family, living in my house, built with my own hands. But when it comes to pay school fees, I start sweating. I'll start fidgeting. Akukale, you will really call that you paid my last house rent. We are both in the same line of business. You joined this business 10 years ago. I have carefully watched your business grow to what it is today. Just a while ago, I saw the deputy governor of the state leaving your compound.
Look at how well you are. Look at how well you are.
Chief, please, I want to know the secret.
What is what?
I mean, the secret of your wealth. What have you done to succeed where people like you have failed?
Mm-hmm.
himself. If I have made any progress, success in my life, all thanks and glory go to God Almighty.
Akukaya, everybody says this. We all know about this.
But we also know that we are lying to ourselves. I have heard thoughts, rumors, and whispered words that our people are afraid to speak of. And that is what I am asking you to let me do. I want to know, Chief, that extra thing that I need to do to have the kind of money you have.
The extra thing I would recommend is hard work. Hard work, trust, and reliance on God and His word. Reliance on the one who says he can take a beggar from the dunghill and sit him right there in the midst of princes.
Akaya, there you go again. I know those words. I know those conditions. But I tell you, in life, nothing stands alone. If a blind man is not led across the road, most times he walks into an oncoming vehicle with his eyes wide open. Chief, Akaya, I almost make a promise.
Give me what you know how much. I am very willing to do anything.
Well, I have told you what I know and what I did to make my money. That is it, brother. If you have come here to suggest anything else, then please do not come to my house again. Me and my household, we will serve the Almighty Living God.
Ha!
Ebube!
Ebube,
I know you very well. I will do what you need. Have this. Go ahead, take it. Come over to my office tomorrow morning. But, Alex and Baluin knows only God, the one and true living God, Jesus Christ. And I will advise you that you should channel your focus and energy in that direction. And you know what? It is never too late. Call upon God anytime, anywhere. He will always, always answer you. All right. You go. Have money in your hand.
I've got it. Thank you for this much. But I see the 6 on 97. I see the 6 on 97. I want to be like you. I want to be like you, Akaya.
Yes.
Money, right?
What else?
What more did he say he wanted?
Nothing.
Mm-hmm. Chief, you and I know that that is not totally true. I never heard him ask you to show him how you made your money.
So?
But I hope you did not go telling him anything. Listen, you can't go out and your enemies reach what you took while hunting after the same antelope.
Alice, you make me laugh. If I was such an idiot like you think I am, no, definitely not living in this kind of house and enjoying the kind of wealth that you do right now. So, my dear man, would you be so nice if you invest a little more confidence in me?
I'm sorry, I mean, it's just that I know you too well. Okay, and I know that in your generosity, you can just forget the things that you're not supposed to forget. And you've seen how many times you spread it, and so wide in that same generosity, which always ends up putting us in trouble.
Oh,
Do not be afraid.
Who are you? Whatever you are, do not harm me, please.
You did not tell him the truth. You lied.
But you were right
when you said that I am the one who can take a beggar from a dunghill and sit him among princes. So, what are you looking for in that dunghill when I have separated you? Come out of them. For that where you are in is the place of destruction and perdition. Come out of them and be.
What happened?
I should be asking you that. How come you're sleeping fully dressed?
I was standing and talking to...
On the phone?
Never mind.
So where are you going to? I thought I just served your food. Alex.
Hey.
Alex. Alex. Hey.
That need to be addressed.
Oh,
thank you for forgiving. I had a good station just now. If I knew, I would definitely know how to handle it. That's why I called. I have questions. Questions that need answers. I need to know what to do. What is you? Forgive me.
but do what I like. A friend of mine had come to my place earlier today, asking me what I do to make my money. And then he left. I walked into my bedroom, and this figure just stood there. It had no face and no shape. And it told me that I lied to my friend.
There is no lie. Only a wrong perception of that which is spoken.
It also told me to leave the nativity, the place where I am. It said that it is a place of perdition and destruction.
A breach in your defenses. You have allowed evil spirits to walk into your home, and unknowingly you have done something wrong to attract their presence. No spirit can walk this path. If they do, then it is a tear in the fabric of time, space, and dimensions. They come in to deceive and to kill. We have the power to send them back to the nethers, the bottomless pit, where they come from. The weight of authority you carry is sufficient to repel those who seek your destruction.
Forgive me, native. Far from it that I doubt your words, powers, or your knowledge. But this spirit touched me. And I went into darkness. But its presence never inspired any form of fear, or not. It inspired calmness and peace. Peace like I have never, ever felt before.
Deceiving spirits. Lying demons. They cannot give peace. They cannot grant wealth. That our master, and he did not permit any spirit to visit you. Go and repair it. Go and repair the breach, the opening from where they entered. You know what to do.
Of course. The sacrifice will be arranged immediately.
Good.
His Excellency, the Deputy Governor, asked me to table his regrets. The President had called for an emergency Council of State meeting over the tribal killings in the north, and he just has to be there, knowing that the Governor is in this coast.
It is a good thing. The Governor will pass on after the moments of the worship of tomorrow's night.
Thank you once again for the audience.
Sometimes I wonder whether it is not the same business we are all in. I mean, I have not met anybody for the past 2 weeks. Everybody says there is a slump in the building and construction industry. I go to a man who is in the same business with me. He dips his hand in his pocket and carelessly gives me 75,000 naira without thinking about it, without batting an eyelid. Some man turns around and says to me, if the money is not enough, that I should come to his office by tomorrow and he will give me more.
Are you not happy that he gave you this money?
That is not the issue.
I'm happy, at least you have some money
here. Amara, that is not what I am talking about. That's not what I'm talking about. Where is all this money coming from? That's the question.
I thought you said you will ask him.
Well, I did. The man almost sent me out of his house for insinuating that there's something else he does for the man. He swore that God is behind his money. Now tell me, Amara, what sin have I committed? This same God that I tried so much to worship has bluntly refused to give me money.
Maybe you are not worshiping him right.
Did I hear you right? Don't I go to church every Sunday and every Tuesday? Don't I go to any morning prayers before going to the market on Saturday? Don't I pay my tithes and give for the building fund? So, what else is he doing that I'm not?
What else do you want me to say now? Do you see?
Anyway, whatever it is they are doing to make all this world, I'll find it out. I'll find out.
What?
But it gets to me. It gets to me. It baffles me.
What?
That every time he gives me this money, I don't know what I've done with it. The next moment the money is finished. That goes to suggest that there's something else they do with this money.
No, I don't know. I don't know.
But at least God is using me to bless us.
Cynthia. Daddy, are you okay? Daddy. Where are you coming from? Chief, you know that ignoring me is not going to solve any matters. So you might want to tell me. What's going on?
I went to see the chief priest.
What for?
I had a visitation when I went up to my room. You were downstairs. A ghost, spirit, whatever. He came to me and he left me a warning.
A warning?
Oh yes, that was why you found me asleep. I had no intentions of going to bed at that time. But he came to me and he touched me and then I just passed out. And the next thing I woke up and I saw my shoes carefully arranged. That much I can remember.
You know, when I was coming upstairs, along the stairway, I actually felt something brush past me. You know, I couldn't tell if it was a human being or, I don't know, because I didn't see what it was. But I was very certain that something had just brushed past me.
He told me to leave the nativity.
Why?
He said that it is a place of perdition and destruction.
Why is that?
Like I said, I asked the chief priest and he said that there has been a breach in the wall of space and time around me and I have to repair it.
A sacrifice. So have you made arrangements?
Oh yes, I called the boys. Should be on the way.
Hey, be careful, babe.
Of course. You know I always will be careful. Always. Let me go take a shower and prepare. Let me know when the boys get here.
Okay, would you want something to eat?
My head says move against the wind, but my heart says move where the wind blows. How do I make my heart go where my head goes? Yeah, my head says move against the wind, but my heart says move where the wind blows. How do I make my heart?
You have not been given the permission to walk the face of the earth. Neither have I given you the right to walk into my room. Stop manipulating my mind this minute, I order you. Stop disturbing my peace, or I will call down all the powers of the nativity and you will be utterly, utterly destroyed.
I am the Lord, who has instructed me from the foundations of the world. And say no when I have said yes. Where can you go to hide from the one who knew you before you were formed in the dead?
What? Are you out of your mind? You spent 2 million
when they are proclaiming that the why in hell would you want to set her free?
Listen, Alice, I know what I saw. I know what I saw. It was deep. Right now, I cannot fully understand it, but until I do, do something that will call down the wrath of the powers that be upon my head.
She made me laugh. Powers that be? Do I need to remind you, my darling, that there is just one power that be? And that is the power of the Trinity. The chief priest who was the spirit, his son, Baphomet, and of course, Lucifer, who was the Lord and the son of the burning.
What if this is not true? Huh? Tell me, what if this whole thing they've been telling us, what if it's not true? Listen, I know what I saw. I saw it. It was deep. No matter what, spoiler. And also, it was not an illusion of darkness. It was deep.
You have gone crazy. You are insane. Alice, do you mean from 8 years old? Alice!
My head says move against the wind. But my heart says move where the wind blows. How do I make my heart go where my head goes? Yeah, my head says
move against the wind.
But my heart says
move where the wind
blows. How do I make my heart
go? Take her out and set her free. Chief heard me. I said take her out of this compound this minute and set her free.
Chief, don't you think you're making a mistake?
Yay! My head says
move against the wind.
But my heart says
move where the wind blows.
How do I make
my heart go where my head goes?
Well, there's nothing in this life I can't handle if I try. It's easy for me to say that I don't have a choice at all. Is it pain? Is it sweetness? Is it joy? Is it sadness? Is it good or is it evil? It's on me to make a choice.
I have sinned against God and man. Pray for me. I am involved in a cult.
I don't know them. They came. They said they were looking for their niece. So I decided to help out since I was already at the school gate. So I joined them in the car.
So what happened next?
That was the only thing I knew.
So what happened next?
I saw myself in a house.
Jesus Christ.
With two men inside. I could see them, but I could not move. Then another man later came in and joined them.
So?
He said he wanted to know if I'm a virgin.
Do what?
So then,
he did?
Told them to pull off my clothes.
When my boys were preparing the girl for sacrifice.
Has he ever spoken to you?
Oh yes. Oh yes, he spoke to me clearly. He told me to leave the place where I am, that it is a place of destruction and perdition. What I do not understand, Father, is why me? Why would God choose me? Why would you choose a man like me, a man who has his hands stained with so much blood? Why me? After all, nobody forced me to serve the devil. I choose to do it myself. Why me?
Listen, my son. You did that in ignorance. As regarding why you, God's law is not like human law. God knows that sometimes we do not know the right thing, or even the right way to frame it. That's why we make mistakes here and there. So don't bother yourself, my dear. But by the way, what happened here?
I told my boys to set her free.
Nice thing you have done. Nice thing you have done.
Father, what do I do? What am I supposed to do now? I hear voices. Voices in my head. What do I do?
My son. All you have to do is to surrender yourself, whole and entire, to God. Never let us remember.
Ha 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 ha!
I belong to no man. Hear me? I belong to no man. I belong to my God.
To the nativity, the cult, not you. So if I decide at this point to leave the cult, it is strictly my prerogative, not yours.
Even think about the consequences. Do you think about what the nativity could do to you? Do you even think about what would happen to us? Did you?
Oh, jeez. Can we just have silence, please? Silence. Silence. Just enjoy the quiet environment. Alice, there is nothing, I mean absolutely nothing to be afraid of. I may not know what about the Bible, but I know that the Word of God says that the devil is like a roaring lion looking for whom to devour. Now, the Bible didn't say that the devil is a lion. It said that the devil is like a lion. Now I know that in our foolishness and quest for wealth, we have been worshipping the devil for quite a while now. Right now, it is enough. God has touched me and I will no longer worship.
Oh, shut up! Just shut your mouth! For Christ, what are you vomiting? Has madness touched your head? Oh, Alice, you think that you can stand the wrath of the nativity when it comes down on you? No, you can't!
Fully understand what I'm doing, what is happening to me, but one thing I know, that right here in this room, God visited me, he touched me, and he told me to leave the nativity, and that is exactly what I have done. I will no longer worship the devil, ever. And please, my dear wife, I do not want to talk about this again.
My enemies have decided to use my own husband against me. It will not work for you. Alice, by the way, it will not work for you. I promise you, it will not work for you. You! Oh, so Alice, you want to send me back to the village? Your plan is to send me back to the village to poverty, but to fear. I bet you, in this house, you will receive hot water from morning till night again. It will not work for you. Nonsense.
For five people, vegetable salad and inclusive.
Bonaventure,
I told you I'll be having five visits in prison, and I want you to be around to them personally. So please, why don't you? Postpone your travel until tomorrow.
It's all right, follow me.
Okay, thank you.
How are you?
Good morning, Bob.
Good morning, sir.
When I was burning the clothes, this force hit me now. And then a voice that said that its inscription is on my heart and not on the clothes.
My son, I hope you never expected that the devil will keep quiet after you have slapped his face.
No way. For sure he will react, and his reaction will be very violent. But the word of God tells us that the weapons of our warfare are not carnal, but are mighty through God to the pulling down of strongholds and casting down imaginations and putting into captivity every thought, notion, or idea that exalts itself above the knowledge of God. My son, what matters here is not really what the devil has done in your life in the past, or what he's doing now, or what he plans to do in the future, but how much of the knowledge of God you have that really matters. So what you should do now is to start applying knowledge of God, my dear.
That's exactly what
you do. Oh, then let us go to the chapel.
From the arms of darkness when I'm about to knock him.
and the fire from coming. But sir, what is this thing that I'm hearing about my good friend Chief Mbadiwe?
Mbadiwe pains my heart. Our master has great plans for him, but he has decided to follow the enemy, and that shall become his destruction.
My wish, my lord, I ask that you have been in talk with him. Of course, he's my very good friend. And moreover, we need to know what has led him to this point. I strongly believe that this is a direct attack on the nativity, and we must fight.
I grant your request, but you have only one opportunity to bring him back. After that, the full weight of the Nativity's wrath will descend on him.
Thank you, my lord. Thank you. I will do my very best.
Oh, come on, Your Excellency. You don't have to do that. You just told me you were coming. I would have stopped everything I was doing to be with you. But still, you would have sent for me.
It was not necessary. Good Brandon. Your wife took very good care of me.
Oh, so where is she now?
She has gone upstairs to freshen up.
Okay, so to what do I owe this honor?
Haven't I visited you before?
Of course you have, Your Excellency, but never without my consent.
I came in last night and I visited the chief priest. I was intimated of your rebellion. He said that you refused to take the sacrament and also you refused to do the sacrifice that is demanded of you. What is your grievance?
I have no grievance, Your Excellency.
So why did you refuse to do those things that are expected of you? And the most sacrilegious of all, why do you have to burn your vestment?
With due respect to you, Your Excellency, the man seated before you is close to 40 years old, and that makes me an adult, which means I owe nobody no explanation for my actions.
You sound like a rebellious child. But you were. We are all members of the Nativity. And there are rules governing this Nativity. Everybody must obey those rules. You are not an exception. You did badly, very badly. You will have to go and settle with the native every of the differences you have with him and make sure you pay up your dues.
Well, I still know that in this country, we have freedom of worship and association. So, I have decided not to worship with you people anymore. I won't have a problem with the members of the Nativity, no. I just want to be left alone. I have found God. I have found Jesus Christ. I am on his side now.
This is the crassest, most stupid level of irresponsibility that I have yet read. Akalia, what do you understand by being on God's side? Who is God but the one we serve? Who is God but the one who has given us the beauty, the wealth, and the power to rule in this world? Who is God but the one who is the Son of the morning? Akukalia, who have you allowed to bewitch you? Who?
Nobody has bewitched me, Your Excellency. On the contrary, you are the one who has bewitched me. All of you, members of the Nativity. All of you who engage in demonic sexual urges with me. You know,
your duty, spilling innocent blood every heartbeat. You know what you have enriched and confused. Chief Alex Emanuel is in his own senses.
Money is of no consequence.
You don't know the truth. If it is more money than you need, you can appeal to the chief. Access to more resources without them to the family. If it is more power and influence than you can raise.
I do not need anything from the
government. I'll pretend I didn't hear that. I appeal to the chief priest to give me an opportunity to talk with you because of the relationship I have with you. And he was magnanimous enough to give it. I would rather that you listen to the voice of reason because you may not have fully comprehended the extent of the power and reach of the Nativity family.
Akukalia,
it can crush you like the moth underneath the feet of an elephant. One more thing. His Excellency will be passing on this night, and I will be sworn in as the next executive governor of the state. The first thing I will do is to make sweeping changes in my cabinet. And all the members of the Nativity family will have positions in my government. And I have reserved the position of the Commissioner for Trade and Industries for you. But that is, of course, if you resign on this, your foolish madness. Madam, please advise your husband.
Thank you. Have a nice day, Your Excellency.
Chief.
Not a word, man. Not a word.
Okay, fine. Listen. You agreed not to fight over this issue. Okay? But let's be reasonable here. His Excellency has said everything. He is told what you start to gain if you go back to the Nativity. You will remain the commissioner who will give him so much wealth and power than we've ever had. What will it cost for you to accept that?
My soul.
And it will cost you your soul if you reject it. For Christ's sake, Alex. You of all people know the God that you serve. Do you know the power that the Nativity wields? The one who can make and break? Who can kill your body and your soul?
Leave me alone, Satan. Next
will come after you. He will crush you into powder, then your body will destroy you. Don't you get it?
You see, that is exactly my point. That is what I've been trying to tell you. My dear wife, is that the kind of God you want me to continue serving? Huh? A God who destroys. God who delights in lasciviousness and immorality. A God who glories in spilling innocent blood every other day. Monday to Sunday, we spill blood. That is all we do. We spill blood. Is that it? Oh, please. Chief Alex, by the way, will no longer be part of that God. No.
All the gods are the same. They delight in the same exact thing. What is the difference in the blood of rams, goats, sheep, and that of humans? Blood is blood. Do you know what those priests you want do with those little ones when you're not there?
Of course I do.
Of course you don't. You serve the God that has taken delight in you and has stressed for his hand of friendship, which you so stubbornly are rejecting. Listen to me. Do not allow the love that he has for you turn into hate. Because my dad, you cannot stand the wrath of Lucifer.
Wickedness is taking over the state. The governor did not die last weekend. He was killed.
By who?
By the native team. The cult group that I belonged to. Their plan is to take over the state this weekend. So the first thing they did was to approach the deputy governor and get him on their side. Then they went for the governor and he refused. So they struck him with an illness. Even in that condition, he made it clear to them that he would rather die than serve the devil. So they killed him.
So now that the governor is dead, what next?
The deputy governor was sworn to that. He told me that the first thing he could do would be to make sweeping changes in his habits. Only members of the nation will be involved. That's actually the first step in the grand plan to hand over the state to Satan, the sorcerer of this country. I guess that was why God chose me from the Lord to expose the wickedness that they want to penetrate.
This is beyond what I have thought initially. Children, we have a fight on our hands.
Yes. Yes, we do have a fight, but Father, what do I do? How do I stop that a man of clean lips and a nose in these things? How do I speak? How do I combat them?
No. Let me tell you one thing. Whoever the Son of Man sets free is free indeed. God, our Almighty Father, has called you clean. I saw you clean indeed. Condemn not yourself and worry not yourself about how you go about the whole thing. If really he is the one who spoke to you, for sure he will tell you what to do until you put it in time.
That is actually what I'm trying to confuse. Since I left the cult, we have no idea to do. Because demons will feel the pit of death and darkness, for the intimacy they have been tormenting.
My son, God has his ways, and his ways are different from those of men. The Bible tells us that eyes have not seen, ears have not heard. Neither has it ever entered into the hearts of human creature what God has in store for his beloved ones. What has shown us that from the Spirit? Children, if you will see the Holy Spirit, the Holy Ghost, he will empower you, he will energize you, he will give you photographic memory to remember all of your thoughts. He will stand by you. He will protect you. He will give you a new soul, a partition in your heart. The Holy Spirit of God will tell you what to do at any point in time. That's all.
Something good enough for my husband's swearing. As what?
Shh, don't tell anyone, okay? Listen, my husband has been nominated for a position in the government.
In which government? The government just died this morning.
Hey, the old man was going to die anyway. Listen, the present deputy governor is going to be sworn in as the new governor this evening. And you know, he's a personal friend of my husband.
You don't say.
So you're speaking for the wife of the Commissioner of Trade and Industries. That's why I'm here.
I envy you, but I'm very happy for you.
Look, girl, I need to stand out at that event. You know how I like to look now. I mean, these other women, I don't want anybody to outdo me this time around.
So I need to sort it, like real, I want something really elegant.
Anything I want, yes.
Okay, but bring them now, let me say them after, I'm not sure. Okay.
Belinda, bring the finest that you have, eh?
Ah, wait a minute.
Don't worry, money is not a problem.
Hello?
Hello, Alex.
Alex, where are you?
Yeah, I've been busy.
You're busy?
Alex, as you're getting busy, I hope you do not forget the fact that today is a ceremony of Dr. Johnson.
And you have to be there.
Did anyone invite you?
Do we have to be invited to an event of the same man who put in his cabinet?
And someone somewhere told you that I've accepted to serve in the cabinet.
Alex, why are you rejecting every good person? Why would you even think of not signing up to Dustin's cabinet? Or you think it's every day that one is called upon to become a commissioner?
Listen, Alex, I don't wish to have this discussion right now. I have something very important to attend.
Something more important than us moving into a decent society? Something more important than us becoming the leader of the state? Listen, Alex, I am coming to that house right now, and I'm going to get ready and go for that event. And if you better be back one more time. Look, Alex, if you think it's our time, you're not going to get the
heart. Move against the wind, but my heart says,
over the windows,
how do I make
my heart go
when my head goes?
Sorry, I kept you waiting while going to freshen up. I hope you've not been very bored.
Oh, no, no, not exactly. The wine has been keeping me company.
Oh, fantastic. Actually, I just got off the phone with him. He's almost here.
Really?
Yes.
Oh, that's good. That's good. By the way, the swearing was a huge success.
Oh, my God. You couldn't say that again. It was huge. Oops. He's here.
Really?
What are you doing in my house, Mr. Commissioner?
We're not quarreling. I didn't see you at the swearing-in, so I came to find out why.
Well, I was not invited. And even if I was invited, I would not have come. I ask you again, what are you doing in my house?
Like I said, we are not quarreling. I, my entire family, our families, and your wife, at least, was at the swearing-in ceremony, but we did not see you. So I came to find out why you were not there.
I have no reason to quarrel with you, Mr. Commissioner. You called me to tell me you were coming. I made it categorically clear. I said no. I will not entertain any member of the Nativity in my house. I have rejected the devil and everything that is associated with me.
Jifaku Kalia, we might belong to a family, but it holds all devil worshippers.
Let me ask you this, Mr. Commissioner. How many lives, souls have you sacrificed, risked?
But how has that got to do with this? Look, sacrifices are essential.
To secure your life, to help your business grow, to appease the devil for the sake of wrong, to help you make more money, and what else? Commissioner, you alone. You have sacrificed over 15 souls to the Nativity, to the devil. People you did not know. People who had families, people who had loved ones, who had children, who looked up to them. Souls that were important to God. Let me ask you this. Do you remember the man who was begging for his dear life and we stuffed his mouth with millipedes and buried him alive? Or the pregnant woman who was wailing, crying when we ripped out the fetus from her stomach? And what about the little girl we ate bits and pieces of her breasts and buttocks while she watched, she screamed? Then she died. Oh, Mr. Commissioner, we have sinned. And you stand here, right in my living room, and you tell me that you are not of the devil? Sick-based souls who rot in hell with your master. Get the hell out of my house!
Some things have never been spoken.
Get out of my house.
How can you?
My head says move against the wind, but my heart says move where the wind blows. How do I make my heart go where my head goes? Yeah, my head says
move against the wind,
but my heart says
move where the wind blows.
How do...
Oh my God! Alex! Alex!
Yes?
In spite of your passion, this new webhead to include your name as one of the commissioners. Yeah, it is written that you have to be at Donna's house by 11 a.m. this morning. Congratulations! Yee!
Well, they told me last night, and I told them that I am not interested.
Something is very wrong with my head, and today I tell you, you will find out what that thing is.
You stay. step out of my way, woman. I have important business to attend.
What is loving business? Who gave you the damn business? The nativity! And all of a sudden now, the business is now more important to you than the nativity.
Alice, how many times will I tell you that I have found God? I have found Jesus Christ. I have found God. Jesus Christ is the way, the truth, and the life. Only in Him will you find salvation. It is only in Him.
What nonsense are you talking? What the hell are you talking about? Where is this God? Where is all suffering? Where was He when hunger was running your noses in the mud? Where the hell was He? So now, there is a God who beats you out of the covers, dusted you up, brushed you off, given you fame, fought you, wealth! He now suddenly just appears! And you think that you must have followed Him sheepishly!
I will not stay here and listen to you.
You are going anywhere but to the
Alice, get out of my way!
I tell you the truth, you are going anywhere but that government house. And you will become that government house, but for being like this, or not.
You listen to me, woman. Look at me. I am not cheating, and you will never leave. Leave my house, or we will serve the living God. You hear me? If you decide to do otherwise and serve the devil, fine, let it be your choice. If you also want to take the position of the commissioner or offer me, fine, go to the nativity and tell them to give it to your market. That thing will be the very last thing you will set your foot on.
Stop making noise. Let me tell you something. If you think that you want to dare me, try it out.
Reformation, but it seems you have a dead wish.
On the contrary, you people are the ones who need reformation.
Members of the nativity.
Him who the Son of Man has set free is free indeed. If believing and accepting to worship the one true God means having a death wish, then fine. I don't mind dying a thousand times over.
Kukalia, my friend.
If you only understand what it means
to die a thousand deaths in a lifetime, you will not open your mouth and talk like that, because that is exactly what will happen to you. I gave you an opportunity to become something.
But you threw it right back into my face.
Now, you will understand what it means for both the physical and the spiritual
forces come after you.
I will kill you.
And I will enjoy doing it.
And when I am done,
when you think you are dead,
I will hand you over to the chief priest.
Do what you must do, Your Excellency. I have gone too far to go back now. I know that it will be an honor to suffer and die for what I believe. Have a nice day, Your Excellency.
Akala! Akala! Ah, Kukandia, you are a bit more than you can chew. I will call.
Lord, you are the one who appeared to me and chose me. My life is in your hands.
Why me? Why me? Tell me why I
general inspection of all the containers coming through our safe ports. So, we need to ask you a few questions. So why don't you come in first thing tomorrow morning?
My head says move against the wind, but my heart says move where the wind blows. How do I make my heart go where my head goes? Yeah, my head says
good evening, Alice, I am talking to you. You're up.
What is this? What is this?
Alice.
haven't seen them. Because I remember I warned you. I warned you about what you did. And then you said my mouth was fair. How about that? How did the stamina to start with
You told me that you have chosen me.
choose me to suffer and die for an assignment that yet to understand? Did you choose me to wallow in darkness and in blindness?
Oh,
Father. Help me, Father. Help me. Do not leave me at the mercy of those that I have rejected. Those wicked, evil, demonic people that I have said no to. Do not leave me at their mercy. Don't leave me at the mercy of the world to laugh at me. Oh. Help me. Where are you? Where are you, Father? Creator of the world, where are you? Where are you? Where are you?
But the Lord delivers him from them all. Lo, I am with you all the way, even to the end of time. Open your eyes. Seen from them all. Lo, I am with you all the way, even to the end of time. Open your eyes.
Thank you. than you two seem to do.
Alice, we've been through this over and over again. At this point, I am tired. Right? I do not want to shout anymore. Can you please listen to me? Please.
Alex, I am listening to you.
Listen, Alice. Alice, you are my wife. I have always loved you, and I still love you. Fine, when we got married, I made you go into this with me, and you accepted. Now it's time to leave. Right? It is time to meet. Fine. Look at me. Look at my eyes. A few hours ago, I was still blind. Look at me. I can see.
Yes, you can see. And that is the benevolence of the Nativity. They have given you back your sight. Can't you see? And
of course not. That is because this new God, Jesus Christ, is bigger. Bigger than the devil.
What nonsense are you talking about? Listen, you know, you have to go back to the Nativity. Apologize to them. They won't take you back.
You know I will not do that. I tried. I cried upon the Lord Jesus Christ and he answered me. He opened my eyes. I will not.
Please do it. Because your life is with the Nativity and you can't go anywhere.
Can you please not shout?
You have not heard the last of my shouting. Because until you wait for this madness, I am going to scream down this house.
I have done my best to make...
Someone blew up my car this morning. I had to go to the force headquarters to make a formal report.
That's it.
Look back and I don't know what this is about. Isn't this part of the plot?
What plot are you talking about?
What role are they giving you to play?
By the way, I don't understand what you mean. But the list of people who have been approved to be on mangoes and ties of the country, their faculty are not an hour. You didn't get here on time. And you didn't present the papers required. So your name is not on that list. Subsequently, you are not allowed to import anything into the country. By the way, your 25 containers are with the clearance at the port have been impounded. Yes. And as we speak, our field agents have instructions to impound everything else you have in your shop and in your warehouse.
Thank you for the information.
Those we serve work very fast.
a few days, I can make you regret the day you came out from the mother's womb. Now take my candid advice. Return to the nativity. And all these will be forgotten in a flash.
You to know that as quickly as possible before things get out of hand.
Well, let me get you proof something.
No, your wife is prepared something for us. Good wife.
Oh, okay. Alright, what happened?
It is something to settle down and talk.
Okay, I'm settled. Go ahead.
Yes, Kali said. Some people who know Brooke met us in the village and told us that they read in the newspaper and they heard on the television that you have been made a commissioner. The entire village
celebrated. Then waiting for you to come in a trough. We even mock our neighbors who mocked us and said that nothing good will come out of our family from that. And even went to church for Thanksgiving. Now the same people told us that you have been made a commissioner still say that you rejected the offer given to you by the government. Oh, yes. Then the entire family members sent me and Abana to come and ask you why did you reject the offer. That is why we're here.
My uncles, thank you very much for your concern. I really appreciate it. A lot of things have been happening around here that you people will not understand. It is deep. See, I rejected the offer because I know these people. The people in government, they are my friends. I know what their hands are into, and I do not want to put my hands into the same thing.
Whatever they put their hands into, nobody is asking you to put your own hands into that. But they offered you an honor which nobody in this area has ever received. What stops you from accepting it and keeping your hands away from whatever bad things you are doing?
Thank you very much, Uncle. Please help me ask him, because I don't understand what's going on.
Like I said before, a lot of things have been happening around here. Oh, we don't know these people. Believe me, you have no idea of what I am talking about. If I accept this position without doing what they want me to do, they will kill me.
They will not. After they will not, nobody will kill a man whose God has never been allowed to be killed. Nobody.
Thank you. Thank you very much. That is the same God that I have decided to hold on to. The same God, the Alpha and the Omega, the same Jesus Christ, the everlasting one I have decided to follow. He has shown me these past few days, he has shown me that he is God, that he is the Almighty One and there is nobody like him. The same God that said that the cankerworm and the locusts have taken, he will give us back those years a thousandfold.
This is the same exactly that they're complaining about. You know, he keeps reducing everything to the level of this God and Bible. Everything!
In the name of Jesus Christ. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, you foul spirit! I command you to leave my house! Leave this minute!
Told me that your husband has been made a commissioner. And I told her that it is time I asked if you and your husband are not thinking of doing anything for us, for me and your younger sister. Since you married him, he has not done anything for us. A lot of people are wondering why he is so rich, yet his in-laws are so poor. Did anybody forbid him from doing anything for us, or is it mere wickedness?
Look, Mama, if I begin to explain these things to you, you will not understand. Mama, Chief's money is of no use to you right now, even if he gives you the whole money in this world. If I tell you that I am not sick and tired of that marriage, I'm lying. My husband is just, he's cursed. Mama, can you believe that that man has actually rejected the commissionership given to him by the governor?
Well, sister, why?
I don't know. When you see him, you ask him yourself. Anyway, Mama, the thing is that me, I have my own plans. I have already decided on what I have to do. Eh? And once I get on with my plan, I will take care of everything that needs to be taken care of. So don't worry. Once everything is settled, you will be well taken care of, I can assure you.
Oh, all I know is that I have tried. Even though your father left us when we were young, I managed to train you. The day your husband and his people walked in here to ask for your hand in marriage, he promised us so many things. But he has not fulfilled any of those promises. We are still waiting.
You should not allow people to laugh at us. And at Timo, Mama, it's okay. It's okay. No problem. Like I said, eh? I will take care of you when that time comes. Eh? Meanwhile, I have to worry about you. You know, my husband actually has some issues with his colleagues. So I need to get him. You know, if Edward does not tell me that he wants to see me desperately, I will not have come. The timing is not right. But it's okay. Let me be going.
Do you insist on going this night?
Mama, I have to.
How come all that we have done to Kukani has not had the effect on him? He still walks around as if the nativity has no power. That kind of talk should not come out from your mouth. The nativity has all the powers. Lesser members now begin to think that Akali is stronger than the nativity.
Hassan, your boys came to my place and beat me. I did not argue, I followed them.
came down here, they dumped me in this room. I have been seated here, locked up in this place for God knows how long. Nobody has told me anything. For God's sake, sir, this is me. Give me some credit. Give me some respect. What am I doing here? What is my crime?
Next money laundering.
Excuse me. Money laundering. Me, Alex, money laundering. Oh, Jesus Christ. Nice try. Nice try. Are you kidding me? Huh? Are you actually accusing me of money laundering?
Alex, nobody has accused you of money laundering. But the fact is that I have laundered money.
Yesterday afternoon,
the sum of 2.5 billion was paid into your account. And the bank manager, like every other conscientious banker, reported the lodgment. The source of the money is not traceable.
The source up till now is not traceable. Then you detain me for a lodgment I know nothing about.
That is all we need you to explain.
What do you want me to explain? I've told you. Hassan, are you deaf? I don't know what this whole thing is all about.
Why would 2.5 billion appear in your account from nowhere and you are not willing to explain it?
Listen, let me tell you, this is not the very first time that has happened. 4 days ago,
another 200 million was credited into your account.
This is ridiculous, Hassan. This is total rubbish. I have told you I don't know anything about this. For God's sake, I have phones. My account numbers are linked to my phone. If I get any payment, I get an alert. What are you talking about?
That can be true, Alex. I confirm from the manager that the system of the alert is automatic. So definitely, when money is paid into your account, you must have to receive the alert automatically.
Hassan, look at me. You and I know that this is total rubbish. Absolute rubbish. You know me. In my whole life, I have never laundered money. I've never touched any fund that does not belong to me. You know that this is all part of the grand plan to destroy me, to crush me. All right, fine. Let's assume you don't know. I'll bring you up to speed. My car was blown up. I was about to enter the car. It was blown to pieces. And then my goods were seized. Then I was told I could not import anything into this country anymore, which means my business has been tripled. And now you sit here and tell me that I laundered money. Tell me, how? Answer me, Hassan. How?
The source of the money.
God help me. God help me. Many are the afflictions of the righteous. But God in heaven, God Almighty, will always deliver the righteous. Always. Hassan, do what you must do.
Peter.
So,
he will be reminded in our custody.
Wherever they took our brother, his day before yesterday. And the one doesn't want to do anything.
Up till now,
I don't know what is happening. I don't know.
If you ask her, she will say, I don't know. What she does is driving out, coming in, walking around everywhere without telling us the condition of our brother.
call her for me. I want to talk to her. A woman whose husband has such a big problem doesn't want to show concern.
She has gone out.
As usual.
Well, we must do something about this.
I don't think it is time for us to do anything yet.
Why?
Let us wait till tomorrow morning. If our brother doesn't come back,
then we will force her
to tell us where our brother is.
Makanandi Bosi. Now you go to Bumba. Our dad, Kaibi. Ubudada Kamo. Okalapo. You go Kalapo, you buy them. You go half for that. I got a little. You don't have a
What do you want?
My lord, my request is heavy. I don't know how to say it.
If you do not ask, you cannot receive.
I know that my husband has pulled out of the nativity. That isn't my choice. I know that he rejected the position the governor so magnanimously gave to him as the commissioner of the state. That also wasn't my choice. I wish to say here that I spoke against all those decisions. I know the right path. I know that following you is the right path. And I have decided that I'm going to follow you till the day I die. My lord, I know I'm just a woman. I have come to ask. May I replace my husband in the nativity and take over all that he has done to them?
Woman, do you know what you ask? Do you understand what you seek? The nativity is not a place where married women are allowed into.
But my lord, every man in the nativity has his wife standing by him.
You're not to stand in the place of ritual and sacrifice. Not to stand in the place of the husband, but beside the husband, because the woman is not the head, but the husband.
But when a man has abandoned his responsibilities, the woman bears them. If my husband has decided to go after some strange gods, I should not be punished for it. I should be allowed to make my own choices. Just like now, I have chosen to follow you.
Are we sure that your husband has not sent you back to spy out that which we do in the nativity?
My husband was a senior member of the nativity. and knows all the intimate secrets already. What else am I going to tell him? How will I even stand by a man who is using his two hands to call upon death on himself? I know that the nativity has the power to descend and crush on any mortal.
You ask and you fail. Go. I will come to you when the time is right. Rise, woman. Rise.
Chosen one. She is the one who will bring my song into the world. She is the divine mind whose body I will use to press eternity. Tell her I prepare.
I worship.
I come not to harm you. No door is shut unto the servant of our great master. I go where I please, how I please, and when I please. Our Lord and Master, secrets which only you will know, because you are the chosen one with whom I am blessed with all me. On the ninth day of the ninth month of this year, the sun will be born to Lucifer. That day is going to be the most glorious day humanity has ever seen. Because on that day, he who would save the world, the son of Lucifer, Baphomet, our Lord and Savior, will be brought into this world. Lucifer has chosen your womb to carry that seed. This is why he has been prompting you to join the nativity. Your reward will be beyond the imagination of any man living in this world. Even the glory he has put in place for his worthy servants will bear in comparison to what he will give you. But this eternal glory is not without a price. The salubrious channel that will succor the shaft of this great God is not for the use of a mortal man. Be warned.
Be warned. Be warned.
Rise up and leave this place. I've opened the gates and blinded the guards. No one will stop you as you leave. Go.
Alice, this is the governor.
Good morning, Your Excellency.
Good morning.
So what do I owe this honor?
To the fact that you are a very
beautiful woman. And to the fact that
I always want you around me. Are you still in bed?
Yes, I am in bed, Your Excellency. It was a friend tonight.
I can imagine. I wish I was there.
That would have been great.
Maybe we can still arrange for another day.
Oh well, your wish is my command.
Okay then. I want to see you in my office this morning. You have been nominated to take over the position your husband rejected.
Oh my God, seriously?
The swearing-in ceremony will be coming up by 11 a.m. this morning, and you will resume your duties immediately.
This is great news. Thank you. This is what we all have been praying for, isn't it?
The chief priest told me you have sworn your allegiance to the nativity. Stay away from Akokalia.
I will, definitely.
Whatever has been taken away from him
will be returned back to you.
He has been marked for destruction. Anybody who is with
him when the destruction comes
will also be destroyed. None stands against the family of the Lucifer and still lives. Your official quarters have been prepared and you are expected to move into it immediately. See you at the swearing-in ceremony.
Thank you, Your Excellency. This is such a wonderful news. Have a lovely day. Ah! This is it. This is exactly what I've been waiting for. Alice, it is now time for you to enjoy your life. Me. Alice, Commissioner for Trade and Industries. Let me see how that hits you.
Same man. You need to hear me out. Please. I know I understand this is so heavy for me, but you need to hear me out, please. Please. And you asked me what I was doing to make my money. You were right. I was into ritual killings, senseless killings, blood money, bloodshed. I was worshipping the devil. And then, the day you left, the Holy Spirit visited me and it told me to leave the cult. It was when my boys accidentally kidnapped your daughter that I said to myself, enough is enough.
So, Akukalia, it was you that kidnapped my daughter. My own daughter.
Please, please, I beg you. I know how you feel. I know how hard it is for you to understand me right now, but please believe me, I am a changed man. You know me. I'm a man of my word. I give you my word. My word is my bond. I am changed right now. Please, I am sorry. And yes, I sent my boys to get me a young woman. It could have been anyone else. It could have been any other girl. I thank God that things happened the way they did. Maybe God wanted to use your daughter to get me to where I am today. Please forgive me. Madam, please. Please forgive me. His Excellency, the Executive Governor of the state, is also part of the cult. Yes. And that was also why I rejected the position of the Commissioner with this moment. He has been trying to persuade me to come back to the cult. And I vehemently refused. And they told me that I will suffer and suffer. And die.
That is what this whole thing, the arrest and everything is all.
The truth is, at this point, I am yet to fully comprehend what is happening to me. But one thing I know for sure is that I have been called by God. I have been instructed by God Almighty, the one who created the earth. He has called me, and he is the one who is leading me. And as he leadeth, O Lord, I will follow. I will follow. Yes, Lord, I will follow. As I speak to you, I do not have a home anymore. They have taken my house. Also,
his cross to carry. I have my own new life to enjoy. Have a good life.
This does not sound like a wife to marry. What do we do? Who can show us our way back to the village?
Igor Kalaku. Obudakamo.
Hey!
Igor Kalaku.
Okamo. Are we going left or right?
Congratulations. I watched you on TV.
Yeah. I want 5 pairs of skirt suits. If this one is not enough, let me know. I'll get some more to you. I want them delivered to my house. Not my rental. I moved into the commissioner's
hospital. What is wrong with her?
The doctor says she has
trouble with several other complicated matters.
And she's in life support and is needing about 100,000 for this school treatment.
So, why are you calling me?
I will be here quickly now. We need to do something. How's my mom and dad, you?
I've helped you.
Helped? Stan, are you coming? Where do I send the doctor?
Every time I said I have helped you. I know I'm very busy. My job is really important to me.
Sister!
Belinda, I sent messages to you the other time that I needed to buy most of those stuff you imported from Italy. But you never got back to me. I hate to be kept waiting. No, listen, woman, I don't have the time. I'm a busy person. So whatever it is you have to say, say it here.
I'm sorry. But those ones I sent you were samples. I am desperately in need of cash. And I was hoping you were going to give me some cash. No, don't look at me like that. See, it's money that will pay back immediately my goods are cleared. Because people are waiting to clear the stores, you know.
And so your little mind tells you that now I, Alice, will not share clothes with commoners. Or that my hard-earned money is for you to climb your creeker that you import so that those lousy idiots who run around town patronizing you would buy, right?
When she humiliated me, she treated me as if I'm a piece of rag. Why?
What do you expect? She has become a commissioner. I am still a trader, a common trader.
Spare me. Wasn't in the same place she used to come to borrow clothes a few years ago. So what are we talking about?
My sister, people couldn't forget where they come from. So?
That is why my mouth is hanging open. Have you not seen the sudden transformation?
Mm-hmm.
What was her husband a few years ago? He used to be an ordinary market trader. All of a sudden, he rose to become one of the richest men in the city. That the government even considered giving him an appointment as a commissioner, which he rejected though. And they now transferred it to his wife, an ordinary housewife. Are they the only couple in this city? What are we talking about? There's something strange happening. They are involved in something, and we are going to find out.
Ah, Belinda.
What is her, Belinda? See, I'm telling you the fact. It's a fact. You are not just seeing it. It's so glaring. You are not seeing it.
Ah, Belinda.
They are involved in something, and we are going to find out what it is.
Belinda, don't say something that will put into trouble.
Baby, please. I will say it. There's something happening. They're involved in something.
Don't say something that will put into trouble. I'm begging you.
You are the only one that I'm doing. Unless you will go out to go and say it. I have said it. You are my friend. I will tell you. This is what is happening. There's something strange happening. And we must see the end of it.
The other day, I voiced my concern about Chief Mbadiwe Akukalia. I was told that he's beloved of Lucifer. So what concerns do you have? Why can't we move him away? Why is he walking a free man? Even after 2 days here, arrested and locked up. He walked out of detention as if he was no bars. and he seemingly looks as if he's disappeared from the face of the earth.
Really, my CP, I am more baffled than you are. My boys are normally conscientious fellows. But up till now, one of them has agreed that he had a hand in springing him out of detention. I've also had every one of them on duty that very night, dismissed from service, locked away, and also tortured. And yet, all my efforts to find out the cause of his surprise disappearance proved abortive. I don't just know.
That's exactly where my worry lies. If we cannot locate him physically, why can't the chief priest with all his powers locate him, find him and destroy him?
Exactly.
My boys planted a bomb in his car, but he was not there when it went off. The chief priest attempted to strike him with stroke, but he resisted it strongly. This same man, whom we seized all his assets and properties, walked out of detention, disappeared from under our noses as if we were mere flies that can only buzz and not bite. I think something must be behind me, and this baffles me a great deal.
Yes, sir. Listen, you guys. I will have to keep you close to yourselves. Because if the priest finds out that you are adopting his
powers, Honorable James, I do not doubt the powers of the chief priest. No. But I think Chief Alex Mbadiwe has discovered another power with which he is defying the nativity. That is my thinking.
You are right.
This is 15,000 naira. The only money I have in the house, no other money. Yeah, go back to the hospital. At least let them start some treatment.
Thank you, Uncle. Thank you.
I wonder why Alice has not done anything up till now.
Uncle, I don't know what is happening. Seriously. When we got to the hospital yesterday, I called her and told her what the doctor said. And she told me that she's very busy and her job is very important. You didn't believe that since then she doesn't even bother to call me.
Hey, that's strange. That does not sound like Alice at all.
I wonder what kind of job is more important than somebody's mother. Uncle, somebody's mother.
Anyway, wipe your tears. The most important thing is to let the doctor start some treatment. Let me run out to look for more money. Go back to the hospital.
Where will you get money now? In this village, nobody has money.
I know God has his ways. He will surely help us.
Okay, I pray. Maybe when I finish from the hospital, I'll go to her house and see her. I assume she doesn't understand the gravity of the situation. Mm-hmm. 200,000 naira is very small for commissioner.
What kind of woman is that?
My sister, mother has a way of corrupting people completely.
Hi! Yes! Okay, now that they have made her commissioner, is it not the right time for her to help her people?
Is it not the country we are living in? Do you now see how people are? At least I've forgotten that few years ago, she and her husband couldn't even afford to decent food to eat.
In our world, the other day I was passing by. I heard some people saying that she went behind her husband to take his position. And when the man found out, he went back his things and left her.
Hey, my sister. Anyway, I'm not surprised. I've heard so many things about her. I don't even know anyone to believe anymore. I even heard that she's in a coma.
Ah! Yes!
People! Now tell me, what on earth will make a woman to be in a court?
Eh?
My sister, nowadays, everything is possible.
Take the money that I've given you and go back home. You're not going to get any more money from me. Huh? I've given you 5,000 naira now. Why can't you take that one and go?
Oh, sister. Sister, you're a commissioner now. Money from a mass treatment shouldn't be difficult for you to raise.
No, it can't be difficult. Because I am central bank. Eh? Or maybe when you walked into this compound, you saw that I planted money.
Clock the money now. Come and clock the money.
Oh, sister.
Nonsense.
How much will it cost to treat your mother? Sister, your own mother. When did you become this selfless?
Just take the money I've given you and go home.
Ah, sister, you want me to go home and watch Mama as she dies slowly in the hospital? Sister, you're not doing this. Sister, Mama is dying.
Just take the money and just go home. Go back to the village.
Sister, I want you to go home. That is cover from me for Mama's treatment. Somebody is in position you're fighting for mental.